Hello, Marines.
We would like to acknowledge the presence of the Commander Central Command, Lieutenant General Ike P. Inserto, Armed Forces of the Philippines.
Marines, huh? Marines.
So, mabungkit tayo sa mga araw.
Good morning.
Sir,
welcome to our place. Mayong buntag.
Okay na, naman ang magkaon.
Okay lang.
Maaga lang kami dito.
Hindi dito ba? Kasi ito, delikado kasi tayo sa ano ito?
Yes, reporter. All hands, mind your battle station. All hands, mind your battle station.
Witness a drop and pick up operation to be conducted by the Naval Special Operations Group. Using darkness as its cover, a highly specialized team of divers and demolition experts is secretly inserted in the waters of the land.
kanin man ang ulan eh.
And explosive ordnance disposal. These personnel are also capable in tactical combat casualty care, which is an advanced medical related skill. Focus.
Special Operations Platoon of the Philippine Marine Corps is tasked to locate and destroy enemy by fire and maneuver, or to repel enemy assault by fire and close combat. Seize and hold terrain, conduct independent operations or in conjunction with other forces. Maneuver in all types of terrain and local weather condition, and can conduct limited special operations. They may be embarked in ships of naval task forces or attached with naval operating bases and stations in support of
landing site. It drops off two swimmer scouts. The swimmer scouts reach the boat landing site. They conduct diamond recon at the beachhead to ensure that the area is cleared of any threat before the other members of landing site.
After conducting the recon, the swimmer scout signals the other members of his team to approach the boat landing site. Upon reaching the boat landing site, the team leader sets his team to provide security for the assault and support waves as they approach the beachhead. At this point, he ranges the assault and support waves to approach the boat.
Landing team, prepare to launch. On my mark. Launch!
As soon as they reached the boat landing site, the team leader of the security wave briefed the team leader of the assault and support waves of the enemy's position. The support wave is now moving to a position where they could provide.
While the assault wave approaches the enemy's position, the team leader commanded shift fire. The purpose of shift fire is for the enemy not to penetrate the assaulters in their sector of fire while they're approaching the objective and to neutralize those.
Search team conducts search 60 degrees cubic. Reports that the objective area has already been cleared. Upon receiving the report of the team leader, the commander amphibious task group orders. The team leader now commands his platoon to proceed to the extraction point for an amphibious withdrawal, with members of the Naval Special Operations Group to provide security to the.
From the objective area, the security wave sets up the demolition. After the demolition is set, the team is now ready. However, before the security wave reaches the structures, we're able to catch up with the withdrawing elements. The team leader. The team leader reports to the commander, amphibious task group.
Hot extraction. Request for hot extraction.
Assistant team leader in a command frag maneuver. However, upon seeing that one of his men is wounded, the team leader radios for casualty evacuation. every mission of the Fleet Marine Team can be accomplished with flying colors. Diligence and devotion to duty are the elements in paving the way to a successful mission.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have... We would like to acknowledge the men headed by Lieutenant Junior Grade Randy Blatukas, Philippine Navy.
We would like to acknowledge also the participation of the Philippine Fleet's morning assets. PRP Dagupan City, LC 551, commanded by Commander Andy Maris Pernes.
Kapitan, baka pwede ito. Set nyo. Wala pa naman ang ipon. Konting mga...